I'm Tiffany with a review, and this is the Head UTech Extreme Pro. Taking a look at the Extreme Pro, it has 100 square inch head size with 16 by 19 string pattern. This is a standard length racket, and it weighs in at about 11.5 ounces strung. Let's go ahead and check in with our playtesters to see what they thought. And we're here with our first playtester for today, Chris. So Chris, your thoughts on the Extreme Pro?
Tiff, out of the two, it was my favorite of the Extremes. I really like the plow through of this one. It's much more solid, much crisper feel, and I think most of that just comes from the weight and the fact that the racket was just so solid and stable at contact. It really reminded me of a racket I used to use, which was the Pure Drive Roddick. Had that same kind of nice solid feel at contact, yet nice headlight balance, so I still feel like I could whip it through. Got a lot of spin. Love the response at net as well, because it was just solid and really precise feeling for me. And then, you know, with a good co-poly, right around mid-tension, just a dynamite, because the string kind of helped tame some of the power, and then I could just really use the mass of the racket to get some nice weight on my shot. So fun play test for me, I like this one a lot.
Now we're here with Troy, and Troy, I knew you really enjoyed playing with the microgel version of this racket, so what are your thoughts on the UTech Extreme Pro?
I felt like it played very well, maybe just a little bit more solid. Maybe due to the D3O that they've put in the frame, it played pretty nice and firm. I like that feel. Gave me a lot of power from the baseline. It's one of the most powerful mid pluses out there, along with the Pure Drive Erotic series. So.
And a spin, I know you also like to play a lot of spin, so what are your thoughts on that front?
Open string pattern really gives you a lot of bite, especially with like a co-poly or a monofilament string in here. Really grabs the ball, and I was ripping the felt off of the ball, so I mean, it was biting it pretty well. And I really like the mass of this one compared to the mid plus. Just gave me some more plow through, and that net, I could really tell because the torsional stability of the racket wasn't moving at all, so it's a very rock solid racket.
Now getting some feedback from Sean, who's a Babolat AeroPro drag user. So what are your thoughts on the Pro version?
Well, my racket is really similar spec-wise to this Extreme Pro, about 11.5 ounces. So it's hard for me not to enjoy this one. Really open string pattern, a lot of spin potential, which I really enjoyed. I like a lot of topspin on my forehand. As far as the solid feel of this, like the other playtester said, I really enjoyed it. Up at net, really solid racket. I was able to get everything deep in the court. It was really easy to hit with this racket. From the baseline, awesome as well, and serving. Solid as well. So it's kind of hard to have any negatives on this racket, and I liked it in every single department.
And I've been asking the other guys, what is your string setup that you favored in this racket?
Well, like my AeroPro, I go with a full co-poly or a poly setup, so I was really used to the way this hit. This is a little more powerful, like the other playtester said, than my AeroPro. So since it was so powerful, I usually string it up a bit higher, but otherwise, I absolutely enjoyed it.
And Jackson, what are your thoughts on the UTech Extreme Pro?
Well, for me, I didn't have the same great feelings about this racket as some of the other playtesters did. I preferred the lighter weight of the mid plus. This one felt just a little bit sluggish for me. I prefer my rackets just maybe a half ounce lighter, but it felt good. I thought that when my timing was right and I was able to, you know, contact the ball in front, the plow through was really good. One thing I really didn't like about it was the stiffness, though. I thought in combination with the D3O, you know, going for that slap shot winner, if it was hit outside of the center, I was really paying for it. And just coming off of a tennis elbow injury, I definitely preferred the less stiff version of the mid plus.
And did you play with the string setup at all?
Not really. I played with the soft co-poly, and that worked out fine for me. I think if I were to switch to this one, I probably would use a hybrid, maybe with a softer multi-filament in the crosses.
I too was part of this playtest, and like Jackson, I actually preferred the mid-plus version because the mid-plus is just closer to my usual spec, lower weight, around 11 ounces strong. And it did take me a while to adjust to this because of that higher swing weight, but once I did, I really did enjoy the power level and especially the stability I was getting from the Extreme Pro from the baseline. If I were to make this my own stick, I would probably make it more headlight because in a long match, I just don't think I could swing this racket for a couple hours. And I also preferred for string setups, I preferred a softer setup, so I like doing hybrid with a co-poly mains and a softer multi in the crosses. And that's all we had to say about this Extreme Pro. We recommend you take this one out for a demo for yourself. And that wraps it up for this edition of The Review. Thanks for watching.